single platform, and that's how I came online. I told her that was a great deal. She says, let me know when I want to talk to her. It's January 11th. I'm telling her I just got done with a movie. I told her I was excited. We're talking about talking. Needing to give you a charge card, right, my dumbass? And she says, Biggi is the one to speak to in order to get that sorted, charge card, etc. Have sent him your Skype details, so he has sent your request on Skype. I tell her thanks. Waiting for my t-shirt. She says, hi, Suze. Your show goes on in an hour and 15 minutes. Biggi is just on a call. He will be a while, but you will have you sorted out before your show. I tell her, cool. I'm just glad to be communicating. Let's see. I don't know where to get the link. They're waiting for me in Journalism Academy. This is April 12th. I was right on time. Yeah. Let's see. Pushed me to get that photo shoot. That was in April. I let her know that there's a guy by the name of Herbert Levon Jenkins wanting to be friends, and she was his only other friend. She claimed not to know him. Don't know him, and you are the second person who has come to me saying he is friending my list. I unfriended him. He was kind of creepy. And she's letting me know we're in class. Here's a little zoomy zoom. My new Apple that I bought to be involved with these people was offline with no internet connection. I'm trying to get in the room. Never stress, Suze. Right. We are all learning together. Let's postpone tomorrow's Journalism Academy. We need to get the website sorted first so we can start working on that in training, and it's not ready yet. Plus, we have Lainey arriving tomorrow, so hectic day. Biggi will be in touch to get all bits started so we can get cracking for the next session. That's on April 27th. Okay. Now, this is when they go on the attack against Peter Eugene. So she's saying, you know, let's come on Skype and talk. And what it was is I was supposed to be on his show and he had somebody else lined up, and pretty much she was telling me I shouldn't talk to him and I should not befriend him, and I told her that I was going to continue to be his friend and explain that I actually am somebody that talks to him and cares about him. Alright, I probably pissed her off. We're in May, and you can see we've had very little conversation, as you can see. Now it says, hi Suze, for tomorrow's Journalism Academy. I wanted to ask you if you could please write an article. We are teaching you how to post and optimize your articles, so we need an example to work from. Okay, so wait now. That's at the end of May. And like I told you, when we started in March, it was a trip to WikiLeaks, and I said I'd prefer to get my information for my books. And two sessions in iMovie, and then the Bitch Fest started, which was really more the Brainwashing Academy part of it, I guess. Alright, June 1st. Just to say there'll be no Academy for you tonight. Got some stuff to take care of tomorrow and need to be up early. So you can see she's taken all her attachments down, which is fine. If you have some time, watch this. Right. Okay, so here's Alicia and I in Academy on August 24th. So you see that we've had very few conversations. We've went through the entire messenger, and here we are already. So Alicia and I are in Academy, and she says, "Hey, love, my apologies. We forgot to set the alarm when we crawled into bed. It's been an exhausting few days. Next Tuesday, promise." Now, you see, this is right as I'm blowing out. She says, "Hey, Suze, when you have some time, let's talk." Right. Blow me off for months, and then act like you want to talk to me. Okay. I let them know we got 10 minutes till Academy. You know, I will talk about anything you want. On September 1st, she says, "Morning, Suze. Biggie forgot to set his alarm. I missed it again. We finished up late with Z. Really a watch when it goes up. Like y'all know, I was watching live and making my comments just like tonight." She still wants, this is on September 5th, still wants to catch up for that chat, which was with regards to your website. "We got your message this morning, and well, let's just say we were pretty saddened by the tone. All that you had to say is that you were sure you wanted to take on board the responsibility and that I would be liable for anything that went wrong that they would plant in there or do. Biggi needs to detach parts of the site which are added but not active, blah, blah, blah. I've read this to you guys before." But this is the part you need to always remember. Biggi is too pissed off about this deal with is, nice English, I have taken over. Biggi is too pissed off about this to deal with is so I have taken over. There we go. There's that sentence. You guys went to college, right? Yeah, they took a lot of offense to me having ideas or speaking to them. Oh, this is nice where she slams my career. Here we go. "If I gave as much of my service time as a hairdresser to clients for free, I would be out of business." "We have worked hard and have always been honorable to you." Yeah, you don't want to hold my site hostage. You just wanted that Trionics distributorship, right, Blondie? And, accuses me of drama and projection, and let's get it sorted. Call me, I'm around all day Monday. Just to let you know, saying I should not have to feel guilty or bad for simply asking for my basic rights is pure drama. We have a real problem with this sentence. Firstly, Suze, she likes to say says. Firstly, says, have never deprived you of your human rights, nor should you ever let have to ask us for them. You have complete freedom. Sure, I do. I pay for it. Flexibility with regards to the website. No intention of retaining control. Not sure where my head's at. If I'm going to leave, I should just be up front instead of appearing to build a case allegory bullshit to fling us later like Randy. What, you mean like you guys did tonight? Yeah. We love you dearly and love working with you. Our only intention is to ever help you grow and blossom. Now, you can see by how many messages Mel had with me that that would not be the case, guys. So, let me shut this down. People off charging him for a free YouTube channel. You're a genius.
The old paradigm of media with regards to mainstream media goes like this. Mainstream media has largely been created for the purposes of public manipulation.
Really?
Much of the media we see today is developed to cultivate public opinion rather than being based on information that is useful, helpful, or needed by the mass populace.
And how did you burn the dross out?
In an artificial media creative
society, you were so ingrained in it. I mean, how did you get yourself away from that?
Humanity is,
and how do you not do it anymore when you do it all the time? And then somebody gets you on film doing it.
We are programmed into self-destructive patterns by mainstream media, such as eating poisonous foods and supporting war and tyranny. So this is one of the reasons why we created, as I said, Conscious Consumer Network, which is being meant to be based on a new paradigm of media And at the beginning of this year, we launched Journalism Academy, which was
junior achievement.
You know, realizing that not everybody's at the same level of development as we are, because we've had
right. And since I was like a big dope, you had to get me in there first when I trusted you.
And
paid you $250 for that load of caca.
So that they can themselves operate within an ethical realm of media.
And you know, it's funny, Mel. You always told us don't talk about it when we're in it. Now I know why.
New. As I said, this is something that has
your code of ethics.
So entrenched
lovely.
Into the institution of journalism. In fact, it's an honorary title to call yourself a journalist. Now, I sometimes feel that being a journalist is
I'm a book reporter.
Like becoming a priest in a church. I know that's possibly a bad example, but it's a calling. It's not
a
priestess
of the
money.
It's journalist,
I
that's
feel it.
It
has purpose and it has meaning, and that's why I do it. And because it has purpose and meaning, it has to have some kind
you
of...
You do it because you don't have a real job.
It gives it that strong foundational base.
You
and
do it
meaning.
To try to get money from people.
So the Society of Professional Journalists states, ethical journalism strives
and
to...
And are you a member of the Society of the Professional Journalists? We're going to need to find that out in our next... In our next little undercover here.
And thorough. An ethical journalist acts with integrity.
This is Susanna Pratt, and today is Thursday, January 5th, 2017, 2:55 p.m. in the afternoon, and I've got you looking at all my files on the computer. The reason this is important is because about 4 months ago, I was hacked. And a worm was set off in my computer that took a while to reproduce and do all the things that happen when you're involved in the computer. And this is month 30 for me. So I'm learning the hard way. But before I erase these, because you see, here's why I couldn't get in my computer, right? Is because my main disk was full. And all of the computer people said, there is no way this could be. Well, you see, when Mr. Boho hacked my computer, what he did is he did each one of these that you're seeing. So we're looking at this white row across. And then all of these pictures that have hdqefault.jpg, at least 30 of each. And there's a couple other little pictures. There was some not so nice stuff as well, but I had to clean up my computer after the Geek Squad had it. And it wasn't set back to factory settings, so fortunately I have my stuff. But this is just documenting for the record, because of course, my question to anybody is, when we have such high security and all these internet police and all this high technology, why is it that nobody wants to figure out who hacked you or what happened and go after the person? Yeah, I mean, it's lawless, but I'm going to read over them. This is boring, but it's for a good reason. Okay. Frame.html. Then we have internal card, internalcard.html. Post message relay. .html, proxy.html, push.html, pyv, /embed.html, rpc-shindig, /random.js, saved /resource.html, saved /resource1.html, Sophia's Emporium, youtube.htm, www.pyv-embed.wzw.css, www.pvy-embed.js, www.subscribe-embed.... 18m.css, www-subscribe-embed.js, base.js, content.l.js, endscreen.js, expansion /publ.js. That one was a huge one, duplicated over 30 times. And then all the pictures that are default, the JPEGs, those were from my shows. So I guess it was easy enough to snatch up every one of those and take up a bunch of space too. Okay, and we jump up to this row and, you know, I don't know who this girl is, and I haven't opened it up, you know. I'm getting rid of all this as soon as this video's done, but this is photos in parentheses 33.jpg, post message relay y.html. Okay, those are repeats from down there. Let's see. Yep. Okay. Those are repeats from down here. www-core-2x-webp-v F dot 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 GDG GJD, I'm sorry, Z dot CSS www slash home C4 slash 2x slash W dot 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 Q down slash Z dot CSS www slash 1pick dash 2x dash web pv b web p slash vf geez dot 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 l2tr dot css www slash page fra frame dash two times. There's the long part of it, see? www slash page frame again. And then we have ads.html. We have ctrvnari1.html. And we also have that number two as well. So, I'm gonna get those off the computer and free up some more space on my new Apple that people like to tease that I don't know how to work. And, you know, I'm just going to leave you guys with this, whoever hears it in the future, is that don't feel bad that you don't know everything about your computer, because even the experts don't. And everything we learn comes through intent somehow. So, talk to you again. Bye-bye. Oh, and oh yeah, this is in regard to Melanie Vernay, Spencer, and Richard Vernay, aka Mel Ve and Biggi Boho, scamming me out of $3,000 for a website, $250 for Journalism Academy, and broadcasting through the Conscious Consumer Network. So this is what I got from them, because I would not shut up, and I still won't. And so this is just a preparation of evidence. So, Happy New Year.
that I can't bring myself to say bad things back at them, no matter how nasty they are to me. I just don't feel I have it within to be ugly back, because I feel sorry for them. I feel sorry for them. They are really being used, even if, you know, it's just because they need a paycheck, they've got to do this, or because they're mind controlled, because, you know, I know I've not done anything to hurt these people, and there's no need for them to have this kind of attitude. And all it does is fan the flames of other unhinged people who perhaps have a gripe that could be dealt with in a conversation, but it gets, you know, molehills, it fanned into mountains, and, you know, then you've got a forest fire, and it's all big drama. One thing that this network has taught me is so much love and compassion for people and their suffering and where they've come from, and a lot of respect for those who come from bad places and then decide to take the honorable journey. And, you know, the way we treat our journalism academy, and I teach this to people, is the modern day new paradigm journalist is actually like a sage. This is a calling. This is not because you're getting paid lots of money. This is something you feel drawn spiritually to do. So it's not a job. It's a vocation. It's a calling in a way. And that means that sometimes people have had to come from very bad places to be in a place where they feel drawn to speak out about the injustices. They've had to have suffered great injustice or been a part of some injustice.
Because they're parts of our body. Sure, in your manual walking about body, you had a gangrene limb, you could hack it off. But since we're discussing the all, the cosmic all, there's nowhere to hack it off to, which means if you don't heal it, we all die. You see, there's nowhere for you to escape to. There's nowhere for you to go back to when your contract ends or any of this other bullshit. We're just here. We're just the all. The ecology that we are all enmeshed in. So we really want to start having a grounded body of individuals, basically a restoration of the so-called mystery schools. Those who are initiated into a care-based eldership to shepherd, to guide, and to develop wholeness, to have a conversation based in wholeness, in wellness, not puking into each other's mouths, terrible things that may or may not have happened sometimes.
Is that my QZ? I'm not sure.
Can you repeat that?
Sorry, I didn't know if you were done there yet.
Oh, I'm like well done and burned to a crisp.
Oh, you never just see how thorough you are. You have such a way with words, and for anyone who has to listen to this, this actually has been a very good reminder for me too. Yeah, well, a well-worn warrior on this path, but nice to hear it eloquently spoken, just to remind us again what it is we are meant to be doing, and to remind ourselves, you know, to check ourselves, you know, that we're not allowing the miscreant energies in, and that we're not falling into the distortions, that we're staying true to our purpose and firmly on the path. So, and that is definitely something I endeavor to do at all points. So thank you very much, Dee. That was so enlightening and so educational. And I love it that you put it across in a way that doesn't come across as, you know, too love and lighty, and you're not afraid of using a few fruity words. So it hits home real in a realistic, keeping it real kind of way. And I also just want to say to the people that we have spoken about and mentioned, again, this is a white flag. The doors are open, the table is open. We don't want to fight. We want to co-create. And if you're in that space where you want to co-create too, Please, let's do it together. And I'm pretty burnt to a crisp as well, so if you want to finish this off, I think we are heading towards the end of the show.
Well, I'll open up what I always open up every Tuesday night. We have a focus group. We have a Zoom session using the Zoom application. It's a free app. Anybody who is inclined to come participate in our open forum is welcome there until you're not.
Yeah, it's amazing. There's something else.
See, in trying to learn, I thought you said that it was automatic now, but maybe you didn't say that. I don't know.
No, I did say that, but unfortunately the file that I had prepared got corrupted about a minute before the show went live.
And you know I don't know nothing about that. So, you know, we're opening with that, right? So I've got like 2 minutes. All right. I'll do my best.
I assume you'll be absolutely fine.
Yeah.
Now what happened is, normally when I have a reveal to play, it goes into my system. But for some reason last week, the intro video got corrupted. It means that it doesn't play, and it happened a minute before it was due to play. And I couldn't get it into the system anymore.
Oh, it's fine. You know, I don't really care. It's just about the learning of it.
No, but you're right. It was supposed to be there. It just happened as a technical problem.
Okay.
I had some weird technical problems last week.
So technical problems. When I tried to go there earlier, you know, to the Zoom room to play, It was a white screen, it was all white, and it had small print, and it had my name on it, and it said like 10 to 11, and it had some kind of time attached to it. I don't remember if it was CST or what. And I didn't know what that meant because I'd never been on at 10 or 11 in the morning. And then it told me something that if I wasn't, you know, the host or whatever of it, and that I couldn't get in. And so that's what was going on earlier.
Right, okay.
But I'd never seen that in all the shows before, so I didn't...
They could try to implement the meeting ID might have been, for many Zoom ID might be used. But 2 Zoom accounts, and we do use those ourselves, and if we already use one of those, we can pull.
I got it, okay. So...
Unfortunately, it's not capable of having multiple meetings in the same room, accounts.
It was like a busy signal on the computer.
Pretty much, yeah.
Okay. Put it in my vocabulary.
One minute, by the way. 1 minute.
Okay.
Yeah.
You got sniffles?
It's been a long couple of days.
Yeah. I know.
It's really strange weather here. It's kind of, summer's basically ended, but it's kind of like really weird, kind of a bit of a strange energy in here. Give you a bit of the, you know what I mean.
I know in the U.S., it was,
by the way, forget it. 5, 4, 3. 2, 1, your life.
Welcome, friends, to a seismic episode of Sophia's Emporium. So I hit leave meeting and go to YouTube.
Correct.
All right, Biggi. Talk soon.
Yeah, let me show my face.
Oh. Did you get your hair did yet? What's going on?
No, I need to do it. I haven't gotten around to it yet.
You haven't gotten around to it. Now, do you do it or does Mel do it? Or do you both
Mel
do it?
No, Mel does it.
I know. That's why I was playing with you.
I just haven't had a chance to take care of it yet. It's been insane yet.
I would never give anybody shit about their hair, for real. I just enjoy having fun with it, you know?
Yes.
It's okay. You look fine. You look fine kind of pastel. It's all right.
It's okay. It's different. Yeah, no, I can pull this color off too, so I need to get to it. I just haven't had a chance to.
Is he painting street? No, he's still in the middle of his color job, so he's in his pastel kind of blue. You know, Joe knows more about hair color than most hairdressers do. Just from hanging out in the shop with me for 30 years, you know? But no, you know how the fashion colors fade down.
Right.
Right, exactly.
Weird.
Good morning.
Morning, Joe. All right, sis.
I'll see you over there.
I'll see you over there.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. I'm going to YouTube. I put in a message to Z, and I said,
do if they don't get funded.
That's interesting. You know, when I started broadcasting, I heard a story that in the first year of broadcasting, Mel was hoping to raise enough money to pay her broadcasters. We'll have to add that to the little timeline.
The one down on the end.
The one with the black guy.
Hey, she don't look so good.
No, you know the true nature comes out, don't it?
No, you kind of know you want to know what my real flashback was?
What?
Veronica Bopper.
Yeah.
Like that, when she's on Xanax?
Right.
That face falling off her skull?
Right. That's never nice, is it?
No, that's not a good look for anybody. Unless you're a zombie. I'm just real tired. I ate a handful of my mom's heart medication. I'm not feeling too good.
Well, you know, flak is here in St. Louis now.
Is it hot out? What are you drinking?
Hey, have you noticed how crappy the poor building looks that we used to live in?
Yeah. It's like the gal that's had the fucking heat stroke by the pool. She had 3 Red Bulls and a fucking Monster drink. It was only 103.
Right.
But she was hydrating with Red Bull.
That's real intelligent. I like the ones that mix it with their alcohol. They're double.
Their uppers
stupid.
And their downers?
Right.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Speed up, slow down. Hurry up, slow down.
That's like I used to have to tell Graham, wake up and go to sleep. But that was just like a half a case of beer. There was no pills involved.
So the councilwoman, or whatever her deal is.
You going to Walgreens?
She's a lawyer.
Really?
Yeah. And she looks like, she looks like the what's her ass on Channel 5 with long hair.
Really?
Yeah, the pretty little black girl that get the puppet.
Yeah.
Rock and roll with your sleeve.
Lord,
did
man.
You know slavery's illegal? Fucking quit it.
People are still so confused about us in this Jeep. It's so much fun. I like locking it with no doors and no windows.